Yo, it's Slolo with Slolo Music right here on YouTube with my man Kane Beats right here. The next hottest producer, he out there. He hot, you gotta check him out. YouTube exclusive, straight from Atlanta to the shot of Texas, LA. We everywhere, check us out.
Shout out Slolo Music.
Down, so now 2010, next decade
about to be crazy, bro. I promise you.
This ain't the last you gonna see
us. Nah.
Appreciate you all day, bro.
More than just having so much music going on at one time, you know what I mean? Because gospel records are a lot like that. When you listen to the radio, all the pop songs are the same chords you hear in gospel records. So it's still an advantage because I learned music was important early on, you know what I mean? I just had to learn how to make it make sense. So what I usually do, I listen to a lot of old records. But 10 years ago, the other day I was listening to what's that song? Hey Now, You're an All-Star. So I heard it in the restaurant and I was like, yo, this still sounds like a hit. Like, it's crazy, it's timeless. And the goal is to create timeless music, not records that are just gonna be on our charts for a couple weeks, you know what I'm saying? That's how you get rich forever, you know what I'm saying? So I always listen to the timeless records to try to figure out what was it about this song that made it a hit forever, and how can I do that? You know what I'm saying?
Gotcha. Let's play that Gucci Mane Wayne record.
Titty Boy had called me like, yo, come to the studio. And I'm like, man, I need a check. I'm like, all right, I'm gonna make the craziest beat I can. So it was just really just being in that, it was an emotion for me, you know what I'm saying? So I made the beat, took it over to Titty Boy. Titty Boy, two boys like, yo, this is crazy. I need this beat right now. He did a verse on it. So he took it over to Wayne, cause he took it over to KY and Wayne, and he wanted to put Wayne on it. And Wayne heard it, was like, oh, I got this beat too, cause I had sent it to Wayne already. But he hadn't even gotten his email yet. So Wayne heard it, Wayne just deboed it, of course, you know what I'm saying? So I was like, all right, let's go. So when he did the record, he shouted me out. I was like, oh man, it's on, you know what I'm saying? So even if you look at the record, it was such a hard street record that it's only a record like urban rap record is only gonna get 4,000 or 5,000 spins, you know what I'm saying? So the money it generated, it doesn't compare to like what Bedrock did, you know what I'm saying? But to me, that record is more timeless, you know what I'm saying? Because the hood's still jamming it. It's still going, and then it was the record that propelled me as a producer to another level where people like checking for me at this point, you know what I'm saying? So that's one of my favorite things ever.
Wow.
Yeah.
Alright, I'll take a couple more questions.
I had a question. When you made that beat, you know, that it's got a real nice low end to it. I was using KRK8s, they're like true response monitors. I had to kill my subwoofer because it was just, it like overcompensated. What kind of near field monitor?